Look at that, some dummy cut the rest of it off. So anyways, this was firewood. So red bark birch came all the way from Washington. My dogs ripped this box open in the snow. So I put it in the dehydrator out there to try and dry it out some. So she was actually pretty wet. You can see how much she split. You can see it better in the other pieces, but that's okay. I've been drying it out for a couple days. I'm gonna go with this just like it is. I'm having a dilemma on what to do with this because the bark caused me so much problems on the last one, but there's only a little bit of it. So what do I do? What do I do, you know? I think I'm just gonna leave it. Now I did turn it down here so that it would fit in the bottom because it didn't fit in here very well. And now it does. And I'm just gonna pick a couple colors and we'll go with it. Neither one of these are really what I wanted. That's an oval. Good thing I don't need much of it. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with that now. That's an oval. I needed my resin to be on top. All right, well, let's figure something out. Oh, that's just wonderful. Have I told you guys how much that hurts when it hits you? Oh, that oval is not helping me any at all. So I knew that was center based on, you know, I turned it a little earlier. I'm just gonna have to try to get it round and then we'll go from there. It isn't what I wanted at all. It's always something, guys, always something. Bye. This stuff smells so good. I'm not sure what that smell is. Yeah. I'm not supposed to eat it. All right, well, it's got a nice figure in it. I'm still gonna try to shape it a little bit more in, kind of be fat at the top. I'm not gonna go too much further, because I don't wanna lose, well, I'm gonna lose that. It's ugly anyways. I don't wanna lose too much of this, but I do kinda wanna lose that. So, I need to sharpen some tools, first of all. Okay, so I'm going to finish this up off camera. I've sanded it to 800 grit. It looks like I need to go back and do it some more. I'm not sure, we'll see. I'm doing the best I can here at the moment, trying to figure out what I'm gonna do, but my video is getting a bit long and I still need to build a finial. So I'm gonna finish this up off camera and we'll come back in, work on the finial and then assemble it all. Sure where the focus point is. So anyways, CGS, I thought it had a name. I was trying to find a name for it. So Chris Parker sent me a sticker. He does have a YouTube channel, so over there in the corner, go check him out later in the description below and at the end also. Your sticker is right there, Chris. And then I got another one. This guy does not have a YouTube channel, but he has Instagram. So I'll put that in the description below. And I'll just show you right here. There it is. All right, so Steve from SDF Woodworks sent me a sticker. And like I said, he just has Instagram, so I think he wants followers over there, so I'm over there and check him out and get a sticker on the board. Figure out how to get it off of here. It appears to be Doug proof. There we go. Brother Steve, thanks for a sticker. They're in the mail. Okay, so piece of what I was told was firewood, but I'm gonna have to work on my finial skills. That's like so out of proportion. And I was turning it and I'm like, I didn't know where I was going with it. I was just doing it because everything was off when I did it anyway. So I need to undercut it. It is kind of tight. It ain't that tight, so. It's a red bark birch from Washington. This stuff smelled really good. It turned really nice. A really nice green. And I just finished it in a friction polish. I really kind of like that friction polish. It's getting better. I mean, I don't know what I was thinking. It's just way too big. It is cool looking. My colors kind of disappeared. This didn't go at all like I wanted. When it ovaled out, it just kind of, you know. But yeah, so I got a logo in here. Everything's finished at the Mylan Friction Polish. Inside, and out. So it's kind of long, so I'll keep this short. We'll get pictures up at the end. I'll give her a thumbs up if you liked it, and a thumbs down if you did not. Did I say pictures at the end? I think so. Yep. Thumbs up and thumbs down. Yep. Go check out Chris and Steve. And you have a nice weekend. And we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.